During a night of sleep, the brain and the body go through a number of different sleep stages. Usually we start off with a transition period, and that's usually a very brief period in which the brain is and the muscles of the body are sort of starting to relax.
There are four stages of sleep. Each stage is associated with a particular pattern of brain waves captured on a patient's EEG during a sleep study. Most people go through the four stages in about a 90-minute period, which then repeats itself again and again. Not everyone goes through the stages in the same order or for the same length of time. John Shellhouse's sleep journey begins around 10:30 p.m., with his brain emitting alpha waves that signify drowsiness.
Right here, this is his EEG. This is what's going on in his brain. He's got what we call good alpha, and so that's what we're looking at right here. And then you can see where the alpha waves change. They get smaller and they get wider. They spread out quite a bit more.
And then that's stage one?
This is stage one.
Shellhouse quickly descends from stage one to stage two, characterized by the appearance of spindle waves.
And he's definitely there. He's got some more spindles here, more spindles there.
Stage two usually makes up about 50% of the sleep time for adults. In a time frame fairly typical for someone in their 30s, Shellhouse quickly descends into stage three, known as deep or slow wave sleep.
Slow wave sleep is really a time period for the brain and the body both to relax and restore.
Children need a lot of stage three sleep because that's when growth hormones are released. But deep sleep is also important for adults. Proteins associated with tissue repair are excreted during this time. The deep peaks and valleys of the so-called delta brain waves in stage three are known as waves of youth.
I think I'm missing my waves of youth sleep.
Yes.
You have less of it as you age.
You do have less of it as you age, yes. If we could find a way of recapturing that and keeping it going, I think it would help us all.
Stage three sleep starts to drop off for people starting at around age 50. And by age 70, most people skip it altogether. By far, the most well-known stage of sleep is REM, or dream sleep. Some sleep disorders cause people to skip or have disruptions in their REM periods, which can be bad for the brain. It's during REM that the brain is thought to recharge itself.
This is a time probably when we consolidate memories, so we take things that happen during the daytime and we put them into long-term memory banks.
Scientists also believe REM plays a large role in the process of learning, allowing our brains to sort and compartmentalize information, and they think it has something to do with brain development. Babies spend half their time in REM sleep. That drops to 25% by adolescence and into adulthood. REM sleep gets its name from its hallmark characteristic, rapid eye movement.
Even though the eyes are closed, the eyes are actually moving, tracking back and forth, like you're looking here and looking there.
Oh, shifting back and forth.
Shifting back and forth.
While the eyeballs move, most other parts of the body are still.
Actually, the body during dream sleep is essentially paralyzed. We cannot move our muscles with the exception of our diaphragms to enable us to breathe, and our eyes, which usually are moving in relation to our dreams that we're having.
Some people have a disorder in which this paralysis mechanism fails, causing them to actually act out their dreams. Not everyone dreams every night, and people can dream in stage three sleep as well as REM. But it's the dreams which occur in REM that people are most likely to remember. As sunrise approaches, most people end their sleep journey with an extended REM period.
As the body temperature lowers throughout the night, most people will have their final REM period and their longest REM period about this time between 4 and 5 in the morning.
As his brain waves show, that's right where John Shellhouse is.
We're like inside his head.
Yes, we're looking inside his head. And I have people ask me, can you see what I'm dreaming? No, thankfully. But I can see what dreams are doing to you.
Just after 6 a.m., Shellhouse is awakened from his final REM period, bringing his sleep study to an end.
Good morning. How you doing?
Even though he slept 7.5 hours and seemed fine, Shellhouse does not awake feeling refreshed. Now the work begins to find out why.
One more.
All 25 wires off.
We're done.
In a process called scoring, experts examine the data collected during Shellhouse's 435 minutes of sleep in 30-second intervals. Going through over 800 pages, they discover he had 82 short awakenings during the night, which doctors call arousals. While people don't even know they happen, they can be very disruptive to sleep.
Here he has an arousal. What we like to do is see what has caused the arousal.
I'm kind of nervous for the results because, you know, it's going to be 5 days. It's going to be 5 days I have to wait to hear what's going on.